champions have. So you're all in treat for a very good game. So now we go to Ernie Mezzi, who is announcing the starting lineups for both the Patriots and the Wayne Hills Indians. So as of now, Ernie Mezzi is now introducing the coaches and now officials. We're now looking at the Wayne Valley team. First being announced, the Wayne Hill Patriots. So Dennis, what are your predictions for today's game?
Well, I think Wayne Hills will pull out a good victory here. They almost won against Ramsey. It was a tight game. They lost by 4. But since their Wayne Valley's our rivals, I think we'll pull it out. Since we pulled that out in football, it go our way in basketball.
Thanks. I believe the same thing too. Hills has been working very hard in the practice season. They intend on pulling a big victory out and becoming the crosstown rival champions. Out coming now are the Wayne Valley starting lineup.
There's Heather McDonald. That'll be a very big score for the Wayne Valley, and we got to look out for that. But I think the defense of the Wayne Hills will shut them down today, hopefully.
Out first is Kim Beattie, a star freshman who's one of the leading scorers for the Wayne Hills Patriots. Next was Ashley Kennison, another leadership senior, followed by Jill Konarski. Guard, co-captain Becky Chilowitz, another very high scorer for the Wayne Hills Patriots, someone who should definitely be watched for the long-range shots.
Yes, she is very good. I've seen her in one of the games, and she's got a great outside shot. She can do a lot of things off the dribble, and I'm looking for her to score at least about 20 points.
So the teams are now all lining up and huddling, getting ready for the flag salute, as we all stand now. We are mere seconds away from the tip-off of the girls' varsity basketball game between the Wayne Hills Patriots and the Wayne Valley Indians. each team is doing, the Wayne Hills team is doing their pregame ritual of huddling around, cheering each other on, getting pumped for today's game. We have a good-sized crowd on today's game. Hopefully, it should be a good one for all the fans and all the people watching.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen.
The Hills team sounds ready, and they break from their huddle, almost like a football huddle. Starting five come out to the center of the court for Valley. Number 44, Shayna Gulino, will be... Oh, I'm sorry, that was for the Hills team.
Heather.
Number 44, Heather McDonald, who will be getting the tip-off for Valley, will be going up against the Patriots... I don't know who it is. The Patriots number 21, Kristen Lake. The officials make their final check-ins, making sure everything is clean and ready. The Hills team man up with their Valley. Coach Percy seems to be a little nervous. The official is checking for the perfect ball and seems to be ready. And making his way out to center court, he passes it in. Heather McDonald and Kristen Lake both prepare for the tip-off. And we are underway.
Valley gets the tip-off here.
Valley now circling the outer ring. Passes off to number 12, Marissa Ekro. Passes it out to the side. Looking. Quick passing. Oh, and a nice block. Out of bounds, Valley ball. Valley still has it. The inbound. Pass to number 14. Quick to number 4. Around the horn, number 55. The shot is no good.
What great offensive rebounding by Valley. Doing incredible things down low.
Inbound from Valley on the slight penalty. The pass is in. Almost a slight steal. The shot up, and it is off the rim and out. Rebound again. The shot
Heather
goes up,
McDonald.
And it is in.
It's incredible. She just keeps on going in. She works strong, and she gets the basket there, Dan.
Hill's ball in the blocked press. Becky Chilowich will be passing it in, calling in the plays. Passes it out. Oh, and Becky is forced out in the penalty on number 4 for Wayne Valley. Bethany Monahan.
Valley's doing a very good trap in the backcourt so they can get the violation.
They're playing very tight press defense on them, not letting the Hills get even close to midcourt. Becky just gets the high pass, passes it out. Kennison passes it back to Beatty. Beatty calling out the plays, looking for someone. Passes out to Konarski. Konarski looking. Quick pass in. Oh, Ashley Kennison just misses. Heather McDonald gets the ball and passes it back to the Wayne Valley team. Number 12, Marissa Ekro, passes off to number 4, the shot, and it is good. A beautiful shot.
Beautiful jumper she had right there.
Kennison passes, and it is stolen by Michelle Berry, who takes it back, passes it, oh, and the pass is high and goes out of bounds. Wayne Hill's ball. Becky Chilowich to inbound, looking for a teammate to pass to.
Wayne Valley again showing the trapping defense.
Oh, a high pass by Konarski, and she can't get it, and it is out of bounds. Wayne Valley ball. Lauren Crisati to pass in to number 12, Marissa Ekro. Melissa Eckroth is having a phenomenal season out here. She's dribbling out just outside the three-point ring. Looking, passed back, and it's stolen by Becky Chilowich.
What a steal. She just played the beautiful passing lane and got the steal.
And Kim Beatty is fouled. It looks to be Wayne Hill's ball. Captain Jill Konarski will pass it in.
Non-shooting foul.
She passes it into Ashley Kennison. Kennison looks, takes a shot, and it is off the rim and out. Number 55, Lauren Cressy, with the rebound, fights for Kristen Lake, and it is Hill's ball. Konarski again to pass it in, looking for someone. Pass to Kennison. Kennison fakes.
What a great pump fake she had there, Dan.
Passes it out to Beattie. Beattie looks, takes a shot, and is just off the rim. Beattie again with the rebound. Up again, and it's good.
One incredible offensive rebound and the basket and the foul. Beautiful shot she had right there, Dan.
So Beattie steps to the line for her foul shot. Taking great concentration. Goes up. And is off the rim and out.
Oh,
Kennison with the rebound. Puts it up. And it's in off the rim. Beautiful rebound by Ashley Kennison.
They just tied the score, Dan. What an incredible play by the Royals Patriots.
Valley passes it in. Is in the key. The shot is up. And the layup is good.
Heather McDonald. No one could stop it down low. It's incredible.
Becky Chilowitz, the high pass to Kim Beattie. She's got it. Pass to Konarski. Over to Lake.
Oh,
Lake goes up,
pass.
And it is just tipped and doesn't make it in. Valley with the aggressive rebound. All alone,
great.
The layup is up, and it is good with the foul.
What
and Valley will
pass.
Take
great
shots.
By Valley right there.
With 5:29 remaining in the first quarter, Valley is winning 8-4.
Michelle Berry with the shot right here. See if she can get one.
The Wayne Hills defense preparing to box out, hoping for the defensive rebound. The shot is up and good. Kristen Lake inbounds it. Quick pass to Jill Konarski. Konarski, oh, tough pass.
Oh, what a steal.
Lauren Cassani intercepts it. Pass to number 12, and the hard shot doesn't make it. And Ashley Kennison has a hard time dribbling, just falls out of bounds. Wayne Valley ball. Marissa Eckroth inbounds. Passes to Bethany Monahan. The shot is off the rim. Rebounded by Lauren Cassani.
What a block. What an incredible block by the Wayne Hills Patriots and the ball.
And Becky Chilowitz with the rebound. Kim Beattie driving the shot just high. Kristen Lake with the rebound. Oh, and it's blocked by Heather McDonald.
Valley comes in with a block.
And it is Wayne Hills ball off the knee of the
Heather Lock.
Heather McDonald, the star center for Wayne Valley.
What great defense by Kelly Beattie right there.
The Wayne Hills teams break into open field. Konarski under the key passes it off the knee of Heather McDonald, and it is continuous Hills ball. Konarski to inbound yet again. Pass to Beattie, she's open, the shot, and it's off the rim.
Just short.
And she fights for it, and it is out of bounds. Wayne Valley ball. Today's game is actually doing very well. It's a very aggressive defensive game. Offense is taking very good shots. The pass out, the shot, and it is good. The swish, a beautiful shot by number 14, Michelle Berry. Kennison taking it, pass it, it's tipped and almost intercepted. Beattie comes up with it and quick passes out to Ashley Kennison. Kennison taking it down the side. Pass, Kristen Lake, shot, and it's good. A beautiful, quick offensive play. Valley didn't even seem to be ready for it.
That was a nice fast break by them, Dan.
Marissa Eckroth passes it into number 4, Bethany Monahan.
The three
shot. By Eckroth, and it is good.
Wow, what a shot.
A beautiful three.
Marissa Eckroth, incredible shot for 3 points. Timeout.
And the timeout is called. The score is now 14-6, Wayne Valley. With 4:09 remaining. Very high-paced and intense game going on we have here.
Yes, the defense of both teams is incredible. Not penetrating anything. The offense is a little weak, but I think they'll improve on that in the second quarter.
The Wayne Hills team comes back out to the court. Becky Chilowitz to inbound. Ref blows his whistle and play has regained. Pass out to Kennison. Kennison looking. Quick pass to Kim Beattie. Beattie fighting for a ball and it is out of bounds. Out of bounds, blue and Hills ball. Marissa Eckroat made a miraculous attempt on trying to save that ball.
The defense of both teams is incredible today.
Oh, and it picked off by Marissa Eckroat.
Like I said,
the pass to number four, and it is, the layup is good. A beautiful defense and offensive play.
Right there, ladies and gentlemen. Incredible shot.
Kennison now, dribbling past defenders. Pass over to Lake, and the pass is high end, out of bounds. Wayne Valley ball. Here in come the subs for Wayne Valley. We have
Coach Valley ball with 3:47 left.
Coach Percy also making a substitution for the Wayne Hills team. Number 14, Dana Lynn Bielicki checking in for Wayne Valley. Number 10, Aaron Burke. Number 50, Lauren Schlacker. 10, Burke has the ball, dribbling around, passes in. Quick pass again. She stumbles. Oh, in the key, a rough struggle for the ball, and it is a jump ball, Wayne Valley. The defense again trying to hold tight for the Wayne Hills Patriots. The inbound by Valley. Looking, quick pass back to Burke. Burke to number 14, the shot. It is short and is out of bounds. Still a Wayne Valley ball off the tip from Wayne Hills. Inbound, Burke has it. Quick pass out to number 14. 14 back to 15. The shot just off the rim, just a little bit too much strength on that one.
Let's see what's going to happen here, Dan. I think Wayne Hills will get the ball back with 3 minutes remaining, and maybe they'll get a couple shots off to tie this game before the second quarter is left. And here we go.
Kennison taking it in. Passes out to Kim Beattie. Beattie back to Kennison. Looking for an open person. Konarski has it. Quick pass to Dana. Dana dribbling in the shot, and it is just short off the rim. Defensive rebound by number 10, Aaron Burke. Passes out, and Kennison tips it in out of bounds.
Nice try for the steal.
Number 12, Marissa Eckroat checking back into the game. Number 12, Marissa Eckroat, now dribbling the ball in, just over midcourt, passes it out. Dribbling, look for a shot. Burke looking for a defender, she's double-teamed.
Number 12.
Oh, a stumble for the ball, and Wayne Hills almost recovers it, but Valley just gets a hand in it. Number 10, dribbling it out, passes to 15, quick to 13. 15 looking, oh, and Kim Beattie struggling for the ball, and they both go down. Wayne Hills ball.
Nice defense by Kim Beattie that time. Incredible.
Coach Percy calling in offensive plays. The pass in by Kim Beattie. She's dribbling. Quick pass over, and it is just wide and out of bounds. Now inbounding the ball, number 50, Lori Schlacker. Quick passes into number 12, Marissa Eckroat, one of the star players for this Wayne Valley team. Number 15, Jessica Schlachter gets the ball. Quick pass to Burke. Burke is dribbling. Pass back to number 12. Looking for an open shot. Has a hard time entering three-point ring. And there's another struggle for the ball. Wayne Hills ball. This defense is really holding up at the end of the first quarter. Score is now 16-6, Wayne Valley, with a minute 53 to go. Hills takes it over midcourt. Beattie is now triple teamed, and it is intercepted by number 12, Marissa Eckroat.
There's the fast break dance.
Jessica Schlachter drives up and is fouled and taken down.
She's gonna shoot two. Well, as the first quarter is coming to a close here, then Wayne Valley's gonna have the lead, 16-6 right now. And hopefully Hills can come back in the second quarter before halftime and get the lead here.
Jessica Schlachter easily makes her first free throw. and prepares to take her second. The Wayne Hills defense is ready for the rebound. The shot goes up, and it is good. The quick pass in. Hills knows that the time is running out in the first quarter. Struggling on the triple team. Number 12 dribbling it out, looking. The quick layup and is fouled. And will take two shots.
It looks like Valley right now is just looking for the drive and trying to get the fouls on Wayne Hills and stop the clock and get a couple more points on the board before the first quarter ends.
Marissa Eckert, the 5'4 guard who's a junior, preparing to take a shot. First one is just off the rim.
Number 44, Heather McDonald, back into the game for Valley.
Marissa shoots, and it is swishes around and is good. Kristen Lake inbounds to Ashley Kennison. Kennison looking back to Lake.
And we can see now the defense of Valley is incredible right now. They cannot get through. There's the steal by Heather McDonald, and they're going for the...
arguing with his team, ordering him to play much stronger defense to stay in this game. And it is, again, a showing of the Wayne Valley's amazing defense.
Oh, but she just stepped on the line, Dan. What a break by Wayne Hills, and hopefully they can get a shot before the first quarter comes to a close.
With a minute and 10 remaining, Hills waiting for the inbound, pass to Konarski, looking, quick pass to Beattie to Kennison. Kennison looking, back to Konarski. Over to Dana, she puts it up, and it is just short. But a nice rebound by number 15, Jessica Schlachter, I'm sorry. Kristen Lake looking, is heavily, heavily defended.
Four remaining, Dan.
The Wayne Valley defense was all over Kristen Lake in that last series.
19-6, Valley right now on top.
Defense is just shutting down Wayne Hills.
Yeah, that trap set in the backcourt, oh my God, it's incredible how they just run it. They're like pros at it.
I agree with you, that tough in-your-face defense is just slowly wearing down the Hills offense. Hills is just going to have to get a second wind and try and pull this one out.
Exactly, Dan. Here we go with the huddle, and it looks like they're pumped up. Here's Wayne Valley in their huddle.
Wayne Hills is beginning to take the court again.
So is Wayne Valley.
Wayne Valley breaks from their timeout. It will be an inbound by number 14 for Wayne Hills, Dana Bilecki. Quick again with the heavy press defense.
There's a trap again, Dan, but they managed to get through it.
The shot is up, and it is just over the rim. Bilecki
number
shoots,
14.
And it is off the rim. And a rebound by number 50, Lori Schlachter. Number 12, Marissa Eckroth. I think the leading scorer in today's game.
Heather McDonald, there's no question about it. Heather McDonald is like, oh my God, inside. She cannot be stopped.
And with the quick foul, I believe it will be Hill's ball, just around midcourt. Kristen Lake waiting to inbound. The official hands her the ball, calling in the play. Someone open, and it is tipped by number 50, Lori Schlachter. A beautiful defensive play.
There's the defense of Wayne Valley again.
Hills recovers though. Kim Beattie trying around, looking for someone to pass to. Quick pass to Kennison. Kennison just gets a hand on it. Quick back to Beattie. Beattie puts it up, and it is just short. Konarski with the rebound has a hard time, and Heather McDonald just showing her aggressive power. And we come to the end of the first. A beautiful first quarter defensive showing by Wayne Valley. You could tell that they work so hard on their defense. Leading scorers for Wayne Valley are, I would guess, Marissa Ekro and Heather McDonald. These two girls are just dominating the Wayne Hills team.
Yeah, it's incredible. Like, with the trap on the defense, they just go into the back and they just, oh my God, like, they just get the, they try and get the pass in and they just keep on tipping it, And they just, Wayne Hills cannot just get it past half the half court mark.
So now the teams are resting in between quarters. Coach Percy trying to find that thing he needs for his team to start scoring some points. And there's the buzzer, and the second quarter will be underway in any moment now.
Wayne Hills starting in their huddle right now. And they get onto the... And here comes Wayne Valley as well, and we're going to have...
Second quarter by Kristen Lake, inbounding it from midcourt. Quick pass to Kim Beattie. Kim Beattie, only a freshman, remember, is doing a great job in today's game. Defense shows their desire again. Erin Burke puts it up and just lays it in there. This junior is also making her presence felt. Ashley Kennison with the fake and called.
A travel.
She's got a little happy footed on that one. Valley now is leading 23-6. Inbound by Burke. Having a little technical difficulties here for a second. And a penalty is called, and it is Valley ball. The inbound, look, deep to almost to midcourt, quick pass again, the shot for three, and it's just short. Kim Beattie fights for the rebound and just can't hold on to it. Valley ball.
That defense is dominating Valley with the defense, and here we go, the pass in, Wayne Hills ball. There's the defense shown again by Wayne Valley.
Balecki taking it up, quick pass again. Hills is just trying to use their speed to overcome this tough defense. Kennison shoots and is just wide. Beattie gets the rebound off a tip from Heather McDonald. The blocked shot, and McDonald gets the rebound. She's now quadruple teamed, and the jump ball is called as Kennison goes down hard. This game is really getting intense. Number 55 for Valley, Lauren Cassanti, passes it in. Erin Burke now dribbling it up, looking, fakes the shot and quick pass. Quick pass again to Heather McDonald, and it is good with the foul.
Oh my God, just posting and toasting down low for Heather McDonald, and she gets the foul as well, Dan.
Heather McDonald, the senior, 6-foot center, is really making a name for herself in today's game. Really just using her size and strength to just dominate this Hills offense.
And here's the shot for one. Concentrated. And there's the shot.
And it is just off the rim, and it is a scramble for the ball. And it looks to be a... Looks to be Wayne Hills ball. The inbound in, looking for a pass. Back to Balecki. Balecki over to Beattie. Back again.
There's the defense by Wayne Valley again.
A tip, and
there it is.
Oh, just tips it out of
there's
the way.
There's a fast break for Wayne Valley, number 14.
Oh, and she misses the rebound, and the shot is missed again. And it's out of bounds. A beautiful, almost lucky defensive stand.
Ball with Valley. Number four with the ball here.
The shot by Heather McDonald and is off the rim, and Hills finally comes up with a rebound by Kristen Lake, number 21. And it will... Hills is now waiting for the inbound. Pass over to the official. He's taking it back. It's going to be Hill's ball.
In the front court, man.
Oh, actually, it shall be some shots being taken by Kristen Link. I did not notice that she was fouled on that last rebound.
Looks very concentrated here, Dan. And gets the shot.
In comes number 12 sub for Aaron Burke, Marissa Eckroat. Kristen Lake for her second shot, talking to herself, getting confident, goes up, and it is off the back of the rim, and she gets the rebound, puts it up just short, and was cut in rebound by number 55, Lauren Crisanti. Dribbling down fast, quick pass, Heather McDonald just boxing in and putting up the layup. Just
dominating the paint today, Dan, dominating it.
Beautiful offensive play.
There's the trap defense by Wayne Valley again, showing.
Hill's trying to use the quick pass, and Heather McDonald just authorizing, just knocking the ball out of bounds. Inbound by Kristen Lake, looking quick to Beatty. Beatty's looking, begins to dribble, taking it in, quick pass to Beatty. She shoots, and it is, in and out. Yelis Babbeck, a junior sub, comes in and just misses the rebound, gets fouled, and will take shots.
Let's see how she does on this. Hopefully she can get the 2 points here.
And with 5:40 remaining, it is 27-7 Wayne Valley.
Very concentrated here.
And the first one is good. A beautiful shot. Taking her second shot. Defense and offensive ready for rebounds. And it's just short. It is Wayne Valley ball. Number 55. Lauren Crisanti inbounds it to number 12, Marissa Eckroat. Eckroat taken out to mid. Passes it off. Again, some series of quick passes. The shot, and it is just wide. And missing again. These shots are just going up, but not meeting their point. And it is a scramble for the ball. And Wayne Valley seems to... Kristen Lake with a block. Kennison gets tipped and knocked down.
Another steal by Valley. Incredible defense by Wayne Hills is showing right now.
And a foul is called. A high-paced back-and-forth action between the Wayne Hills and Wayne Valley teams. Hills on the inbound. Wayne Valley seems to have let up on their press defense. Waiting for Wayne Hills to cross midcourt and then jumping on their opponents. Kennison having a hard time. She loses the ball and it is recovered. In the struggle for the ball, Kennison and Marissa Eckroat just get laid out going for the ball. It was almost like a football block.
That's a good one, Dan.
Marissa Eckroat will go to the line.
Shooting two here.
There's a silence throughout, and number 50, Lori Schlachter, just checks into the game for number 14, Michelle Berry.
Here's the two shots, and she's concentrated. There's a shot, and a swish.
And she will now reset for her second shot. The official checks in.
Looks like both teams are ready for the rebound if there's going to be. Here's the shot.
And a struggle for the rebound. Yelis Babbeck just whips down number 55, Lori Crisanti. Play will continue as a Valley inbound. Looking for an open teammate. Quick pass. The shot is up and it is just off the rim. Struggle for the ball and it goes out of bounds. And it will be Wayne Valley ball. The dribbling around the three-point ring. Number 12, Marissa Eckroat, checking in, calling in plays. Looking, she's heavily double-teamed. Quick pass again, and a foul is called. Wayne Hills ball. official calling in the foul to the statisticians, excuse me. And Kristen Lake will be taking two shots. Lake talking to herself, getting prepared for her upcoming shot. It is up and is off the rim and just misses it. And Heather McDonald shows her strength and size and just rebounds with authority. And the shot is good, increasing Wayne Valley's lead 30-8 with 4 minutes and 20 seconds remaining. B driving up fast. The shot goes up and it is off the back of the rim, and McDonald with yet another rebound. And a foul by Wayne Hills, and it shall be Wayne Valley's ball.
Dana Lynn with the foul for Wayne Hills to stop the fast break by Wayne Valley. It was a good foul here.
Number 12, the junior Marissa Eckroat for her two shots.
Here's the shot.
And it is good. The two teams reset for Marissa Eckroat's second shot.
Looks like both defenses are ready for the offensive rebound.
And it is good. For those just tuning in to us, it is the girls varsity Wayne Hills Patriots versus Wayne Valley's Indian basketball game. And you just noticed Kimby just get fouled. And she will take two shots on a tough fall. Wayne Hills huddling up at the foul, at the foul line. Kim Beattie trying to catch a breath before she takes her two shots. Talking to herself, letting her know how to use the right wrist action. Quick dribbles.
Very concentrated here, Dan.
And it is off the back of the rim. A beautiful rebound by Ashley Kennison. The shot goes up, and it is, bounces around and can't go in. Number 15, Jessica Schlachter with the rebound. Passes off to number 4, Bethany Monahan. Monahan, another quick pass. And the Hills defense is now starting to show some stuff down on their side of the court. And a timeout is called. Wayne Hills is looking to have the 3:52 remaining. Is leading 32-8. So, Dennis, what are your feelings?
Well, Wayne Valley is doing an incredible job with the defense and the trap in the backcourt. And they're going off after the steal. They're going off with the fast break, and it's been working for them. And it looks like they're going to keep on going with the score 32-8. And Wayne Hills probably going to go and improve in the next half, hopefully.
I agree. I do agree, too. And a violation is called, and it shall be Valley's ball yet again. I also agree with you and you just said, Dennis. Defense is the strongest part of any game. I mean, offense, yes, will score you the points, but having a strong defense is just so important. It's like that in every sport, baseball, football, anything.
Exactly, Dan.
Number 50, Lori Schlachter taking her shot.
It's up.
And the first one is good.
Both teams ready for the rebound if there is one.
Number 13, Brittany Bonney, a freshman, has just checked in for the Wayne Hills Patriots.
And another good shot by number 50, Lori Schlachter.
Bethany Bonney struggling on her double team. The foul is called, and she will go to the line for her shots. Wayne Hills huddling around, giving her confidence. He's telling her to remain calm and just relax and make her shots. Bonney sets the pass. It's good. Meant shot on that, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sorry. Sets up for her second shot. Team's getting ready for the rebound. And it is good. And that increases the Wayne Hills points to 10, and it is 34-10 Wayne Valley. Number 15, Jessica Schlachter, quick passes out. Driving. And the governor goes up, and it is travel called. Wayne Hill's ball. Defense again showing their toughness late in the second quarter.
Wayne Hill's starting to rub off the Wayne Valley defense here, and it looks like it's paying off. They got the ball, and hopefully can get a couple of shots off before the second quarter comes to an end.
Beattie just took her time coming across midcourt. Wayne Valley has led up on the press defense. Number 14 for Wayne Hills. A Dana Biecki, a sophomore, doing a lot of playing time. Brittany Bonnie fights for the ball, and it is out of bounds, Wayne Hills.
Yeah, they got a little confused on that one. They were both on Wayne Hills, but hopefully they'll get the steal and come back with the fast break.
Aaron Burke taking it in. Quick passes it out to Bethany Monahan. Bethany Monahan back to Jessica Schlack. The shot is up, and it's just wide. Heather McDonald trying for the shot on the rebound and just misses.
Fight for the ball.
Kristen Lake struggles for the ball, and it will be Wayne Valley shot on the recent foul.
Number 50, Laura Schlechner for the two foul shots.
Hey, Jessica Schlechter is checking out or talking to her coach.
First shot, concentrated. Ooh, in and out. Incredible.
Lori Schlechter, I believe the older sister of the two Schlechters. Both these are just a dynamic force together. Hills comes dribbling. Dana, quick drive. The shot goes up and is in and out. Gets her own rebound and is fouled on the shot. And she will get two. Hills huddling around now. Dana Balicki, the sophomore, will be now taking two penalty shots.
Here's the shot.
Taking her time. Shoots. And is off the back and bounces off. In comes the subs, number 14 and number 55 for Wayne Valley, Michelle Berry and Lauren Crisanti.
Heather McDonald just checked out, so doesn't look like Valley will go for the down-low situation in this drive.
Her second shot is good. Erin Burke quick passing in, 2:36 remaining. A struggle for the ball, and it is a jump ball. Wayne Hills, Kim Beattie, a beautiful defensive play.
Taking a couple of plays from Wayne Valley with the trap on that one, and they got the steal. It was a very good play, and here we go.
B trying to dribble hard, passes out to Dana Blackie, looking. Scott Nolan passes back to Beattie. Beattie with the long shot and is just short. Brittany Bonney with the rebound, and Jill Konarski fights for the rebound, knocking it out of bounds.
That should be Hill's ball.
Shall be an inbound by Wayne Hills' Jill Konarski. The Wayne Hills team begins to break. Trying to get away from their defenders. Quick pass to Kim Beattie. Shot.
Ooh,
and there is yet another penalty called. Kim Beattie will go to the line for shots.
That seems like almost the 10th time they've been to the line, and they're stopping the clock and chipping into this lead of the Wayne Valley right here.
The freshman, Kim Beattie, taking her shots. One of the leading scorers for this Wayne Hills Patriots, just misses her first one. She shakes it off. Resets.
Two defense ready for the
and it is off the back of the rim. A beautiful box out job by the Wayne Valley defense. Quick pass, and here comes the quick drive offense. Quick dribbling in. The shot goes up, and it is off the top of the backboard. Rebounded by Valley, and the penalty is called. On Kristen Lake, number 21 on goal with the foul. And number
fifth time to the line tonight, Dan.
Number 50, Lori Schlachter taking her shots. Another very powerful offensive weapon for this Wayne Valley defense offense.
There's the first shot, and it's good.
Checking in, number 20 for Wayne Hills is Yelis Babbeck, a junior, who will be an upcoming senior next year. A very dominant force for this Wayne Hills team. The second shot is in and out, and a beautiful rebound. The shot goes up real fast and just short. And a rebound by Jill Karnarski in the fight, and it is Wayne Valley ball.
Wayne Valley just showing the offensive rebounding skills in that situation, and they did not get the ball. Looks like another penalty will be called. Oh, Wayne Hills with the ball right now, and we start off 1:57 left in the game.
Beattie passes it out to Brittany Bonney. Bonney with the shot off the back and just misses. Number 15, Jessica Schlachter gets the rebound. Passes it out to number 10, Erin Burke. Burke looking, passes back.
The three.
Schlachter up and
good.
The three is good by Jessica Schlachter. A beautiful shot from downtown. Just increasing the Wayne Valley lead to 39-11. They are just running away with this game. The shot goes up and she is fouled yet again on the shot. And Kim Beattie will go to the line yet again for almost what it seems to be like the third time in a minute and a half.
Yes, if they keep on doing this in the second half and stopping the clock, they might chip away at the lead in the third quarter.
Her first shot is good.
Here comes the second shot.
Seems to be a problem with a substitution. The official checking in with the statisticians. Everything seems to be okay. Kim Beattie getting ready for her second shot.
There it is.
And it is good. Kim Beattie, just an amazing shooter and only a freshman. Just imagine how good she's going to be when she becomes a senior. And a beautiful rebound by the young Brittany. Oh, that was Jill Karnarski, my mistake.
The Wayne Hills Patriots that one, and I think it'll be another penalty situation here. And it's 39.
There's a minute and 16 remaining in the half. Jill Karnarski now to the line. She's just going back and forth between these two girl teams.
The shot.
And it's,
now.
Off both sides of the rim and out.
Looks like both teams are ready.
The second shot is no good, and number 15, Jessica Schlachter. For an open teammate. Quick passes to Erin Burke. Burke driving, passes back. Oh, quick driving and missed. Oh, just missed. Number 55 puts it in for the score. Crisanti, a forward junior, just not letting up and getting the points. Shot goes up and it is made by the fresh. Erin Burke, quick with the shot and it is good. A beautiful offensive play by number 10, Erin Burke.
Wow, both off are lighting up for the right now.
Beattie just looking back, quick passes to Bonney. Bonney looking for an open teammate, back to Beattie. Beattie pump fakes, puts it up, is fouled again.
She just has an incredible drive off the dribble. Incredible. So that's what they have to do in the third quarter to get back into this game. And Beattie is taking the game into her own hands, and she's shooting two right now.
With 13.2 seconds remaining, Beattie misses her first shot. The score is 43-15, Wayne Valley. Just showing an amazing display of offense and defense in this entire game.
Here's the next shot, and it's good.
And the second shot is good. Clock wasting away, 10 seconds remaining. Burke, quick driving around the side, passes out to Jessica Schleicher. Schleicher puts up, and a three with 2-3 seconds remaining. A beautiful shot to end the quarter. An amazing three-point shot from the side. It is now halftime. Both teams shall go to each other's locker rooms. Wayne Hills needs to find something to stop this incredible Wayne Valley defense and offense. Just a beautiful three, and Wayne Valley is winning 43-16. We now go to halftime. We are now back in the second half of play. The score is 45-16, Wayne Valley. Wayne Valley's been showing a great, great job on offense and defense. Star players for Valley are definitely Aaron Burke, Jessica Schlachter, and number 44, Lauren McDonald. For Wayne Hills, stars have been Kim Beattie, the star freshman, Kristen Lake, and now we are ready to go. Brittany Bonney looking, passes off to Konarski. Konarski looking, passes back to Bonney. Bonney with the shot, and it is good. A beautiful shot. Brittany Bonney with a beautiful shot, and it is now 18-45. Valley now driving in. Quick pass around the horn, looking. Number 12, Marissa Eckroat calling out to her team. Passes back to 14, Michelle Berry. Berry to number 55. Driving under the hoop and then scramble for the ball, Ashley Kennison. And it's Hills ball. Oh, no, Valley ball.
Looks like Hills is on the ball right now, showing the defense. And they scored early, and let's see what comes out of it.
One of the Valley players, Bethany Monahan, tying her shoe. A little delay. The inbound in. Up to Heather McDonald. Quick pass back. What a fake. The shot just wide, and Heather McDonald can't get the rebound and takes a fall. Looking back, quick pass to Bethany Monahan. Looking, passes back to number 14, Michelle Berry. Berry back to Heather and just puts it in. Heather McDonald just showing her stuff today. Big players making big plays.
That's terrible.
Kim Beattie passed out to Brittany Bonney. Bonney back to Yellow Spyback. The shot and is just wide. And it is out of bounds and looks to be Wayne Hills ball. Konarski to inbound. Looking, quick pass, and it is taken by Bethany Monahan, who begins to take it up, passes it up to number 12, Marissa Eckroat, the pass, and it is stolen by Bethany Monahan. This freshman is just making a name for herself as much varsity time as she can.
A nice trap by Wayne Hills in the corner, and they got the steal, and we're going for the fast break, but Wayne Valley came back and is on the D.
Oh, and a tough pass, and is taken away by Lauren Crisanti. Passes out to number 12, Marissa Eckroat. Looking, shoots, and it is good. A beautiful long-range shot by Lauren Crisanti.
Looks like everything is going Valley's way tonight.
The two freshmen take it up from half court. Kim Beattie driving hard again, and the shot is blocked. And it is just out of bounds and will be Valley's ball again. The inbound comes in. Marissa Eckroat taking the cross. Passed out to number 14, Michelle Berry. Berry over to Lauren Crisanti. The defense is just starting to swarm around the Valley players. Another Valley rebound. Look, and Jill Konarski steals it away.
Nice defense by Wayne Hills on that play right there.
Kim Beattie taking it up. Looking, passes out to the other freshman, Brittany Bonney. Slooking packs back to Ashley Kennison. Kennison puts it up and is fouled. Two shots.
That was a nice drive in there, Dan, and she's going to look for two at the line here.
Kennison a little slow getting up, makes it her way to the line. Just taking a little stretch, getting ready for her two shots. The first one is set up and just short off the front of the rim. Number 12, Marissa Eckroat, coming in to talk to her coach.
Concentrating right here. And
second one is around the rim and out. Heather McDonald again with another rebound.
I think she's in double figures here, Dan.
Pass around the horn. Oh, and Konarski go down hard. No foul called. Valley was still with the ball. Looking, quick pass to McDonald. McDonald double team just aggressively just knocks down Konarski again. Konarski a little stunned by that quick beating she just took in those last two drives.
Heather McDonald just forced down low. Even the double team cannot stop her. They're looking for two at the line right now. The shot, it's good.
First one is good, just increasing her points today. Score is now 50-18. The second one is good. Konarski quick to inbound it. Brittany Bonney taking it up across midcourt, looking around, trying to find a quick little spin move to try and break away a defender who's on her just too tight. Kim Beattie passes out to Jill Konarski. Konarski holding the ball high, looking for a friendly teammate to pass to. Yelis Babak has it at the top of the key. Nowhere to go. Looking. Quick passes out, and then Brittany Bonney puts up and is short. Kennison can't get the rebound. Yelis Babak holds on to it and is fouled.
Looks like they're going to be going for two right now. Wayne Hills. Yelis is at the line. And she's getting ready to shoot two. Concentrating. The shot
is in and out. Hills is just having a very hard time making their regular shots today. Yelis Babak hoping to make her second shot now. She sets. The shot is up, and it's short.
Wayne Valley ball. Sub in for Wayne Hills,
number
12. Becky Chilowitz enters the game for Wayne Hills Patriots. And Wayne Valley with the ball, dribbling it up.
Quick pass out. Number 4, Bethany Monahan looking. Quick passes out to number 12, Marissa Eckroat. Warren Crisati passes up and is just wide. Tough rebound and a foul is called. And Valley will go to the line.
She was swamped with Wayne Hills Patriots right there. And she looked for the shot and she got the foul instead. See, she's going to shoot two.
First shot, she's ready.
Michelle Berry at the line.
And it's good. Michelle Berry makes her first of two. Becky Chilowitz and Brittany Bonney make a quick switch. Jill Konarski comes out for a number 23, a freshman, Andrea Ostrich. Freshman hoping to make a name for herself like the other two, Kim Beattie and Brittany Bonney, are doing today. The second shot is no good. Rebound by Valley, and Brittany Bonney struggles, and it is, almost. A foul is called and struggle for the ball.
Wayne Valley just using their two top big players in the game to get the offensive rebound so they can get another shot at the basket here.
Oh, a beautiful out of nowhere steal by Becky Chilowitz. Becky fighting against the double team defense. Kim Beattie taking it up. Looking a little spin and foul. Foul called on Kim Beattie. subs coming in, number 10, number 50, and number 15. Aaron Burke, Lauren Schlachter, and Jessica Schlachter. Aaron Burke taking across midcourt, calling in a play, passes to Bethany Monahan. Bethany Monahan, quick pass again. Heather McDonald can't hold on to it. And another foul is called on the Wayne Hills Patriots.
I think one more now, Dan, and there will be in the penalty. Wayne Hills. Sally looking for it.
Kristen Lake. Kristen Lake's little sister Kelly Lake is now checking in for Ashley Kennison, who is high on the foul number. Jessica Slacked with another three, and it is just short. And it goes out of bounds, blue ball.
Wayne Valley just looking for the nice shots and couldn't get it in that play, but looking for another one.
The pass, the inbound is off of Valley's foot and is out. Becky Chilowitz now to inbound. Hills trying to score as many points as they can. The score is now 52-18 with 3:47 remaining in the third quarter. The hard pass, and it is stolen away by Bethany Monahan. Bethany Monahan, fast drive, and is fouled. And is just taken out by Becky Chilwell. Bethany Monahan a little slow to come up, but she seems to be all right. What a vicious block. Bethany Monahan goes to the line.
That was a big foul she attempted there, and making her earn the two at the line.
Oh, and it seems to be a technical. Becky Chilip seems to be getting a technical for that recent. Amazing, the official runs over to speak with Coach Percy.
It might be a flagrant two, Dan. I'm not sure about that one.
Wow, a technical. Bethany Monahan all alone taking her two free shots. First one is good. See, with the technical, you're just all there by yourself. It's like you're in practice just shooting around. Wow, that's just a total morale crusher for this Wayne Hills Patriots.
When you think they're coming back, they just Wayne Valley just boosts it up and take charge again of the lead here.
Aaron Burke for Wayne Valley to inbound. Passes it out to Jessica Schlachter. Pass out to Bethany Monahan. Monahan looking. Beattie playing tough defense against her. Just Schlachter looking for a teammate to pass to. Quick pass to Heather McDonald, and she puts it in again. No fancy shot. No behind the back. Just straight up, I'm going to overpower you style offense. That's what I like to see in basketball games.
That was a nice pass by Jessica Schlachter, and Heather McDonald just put it in. That was a nice shot. Right
there. She just took it to the hole. Kim Beattie now on the line for her yet again two more shots. Seems to be like every few seconds there's yet another foul. The first shot is good. Becky Chilowitz comes over to congratulate her.
Looks like she's getting ready for her next shot and confident.
Second shot is good.
Here's the inbound by Valley, bringing it up the court.
Aaron Burke trying to drive real fast. Jessica Schlachter looking. Bethany Monahan now looking, dribbling back and forth. Passes out to number 50. 50 looking back, passes back to Bethany.
Looks like there's nothing inside for Wayne Valley. Oh my God, Heather McDonald just driving in. She gets blocked though.
Aaron Burke with the shot, and it is good.
Wide open there, Dan.
She had all day for that shot and just took her time and made it in. A beautiful putt.
Wayne Hills was looking at Heather McDonald. She's been the dominating player of the game right now. And they found an open player there, and she got the wide open shot. Here's the inbound for Valley. Valley dribbling it up. There's the pass into Heather McDonald, and she makes the shot again, ladies and gentlemen. Incredible.
She must have well over 20 points today. She is just dominating under the basket. Quick pass, which just turns and just aggressively puts it in there.
Wow.
The shot goes up, and there you go. Heather McDonald with another rebound. Just boxing out, making a quick pass to Jessica Schlachter.
You know she's had a double-double tonight.
Chilowitz to inbound. Quick passes to Beattie. Beattie slowly taking it up, taking her time. Aaron Burke ready to play some solid defense. And now coming to the line is Kelly Lake. The score is now 60-20 with 1:41 remaining in the third quarter.
There's the shot.
Back. And just out.
Here's the score again, 60-20. And here's the second shot here. There she goes.
Second one is no good.
From the back of the rim. Valley controlling the ball. Dribbling it up.
Oh, and she loses control of the ball, and in a struggle for it, it becomes Wayne Hill's ball. The freshman, number 23, Andrea Ostrich.
Nice.
Beautiful
play by Wayne Hills right there.
Kim Beattie now taking it up. Looking for an open teammate. Becky Chilowitz tries to make a pick, sets it up, and Kim Beattie just misses the shot. In the struggle for the ball, it seems to be Wayne Valley recovers and the pass off, and it goes out of bounds. Wayne Valley ball.
That would have been a big shot there, Dan, but went off the rim, and it's Wayne Valley's ball right now.
Valley seems to be slowing it down, knowing that they have a very big lead, just trying to consume as much time for the win. Aaron Burke, again, the aggressive offensive player, passes out to Jessica Schlachter, and she makes yet another three. That's her third or fourth three of the day. That girl is just amazing from outside the ring. Beattie now, looking, passes out to Brittany Bonney. Bonnie looking, who played a lot today in today's game as a freshman. Chilowitz over. Shot goes up, and it is off the backboard and out. Shot goes up by Brittany Bonney, and she is fouled.
She's just playing hard aggression D right now, and she got the offensive rebound and going for two.
Brittany Bonney now to the line for her shots. Just off the front of the rim and short.
Number Heather McDonald coming out of the game.
Number 13, Megan Lore, a junior, coming in.
Just short again for Wayne Hills. Looks like it will be Wayne Valley Indians ball.
Number 12, Marissa Eckroat taking it across. Passes over to Aaron Burke. Aaron looking, passes back to Escrope. Shot goes up and it is good again.
Another three, incredible. She's just having her game at the 3-point line. It is incredible. She's just shooting so well at the end of this quarter. Another foul by Wayne Valley to Wayne Hills. Looks like it'll be passing Wayne Hill's ball.
Looking for an open teammate. Finds one in Becky Chilowitz. Becky quick passes off to Kim Beattie. Kim Beattie the shot, and it is in and out. Almost a three. Aaron Burke with a quick recovery. Quick pass out to... And it is the end of the third quarter. Marissa Eckroat can't come up with that last shot in the final seconds of the third quarter. So with 8 minutes remaining in the game, there's 66-20. Wayne Valley. Wayne Valley has just dominated this entire game. I mean, strong offense, fast offense, and just an aggressive defense throughout the entire game has just been shutting down the Wayne Hills game.
I don't know. Those threes were helping the Wayne Valley right now, and they're just incredible in their huddle. Doesn't seem like they're in a rush or anything coming back on the court. Wayne Hills looks, I don't know, it doesn't look like they're going to be coming back in the game, but they'll hopefully try, and maybe they'll pull out a victory. Who knows?
Now, if I were the Wayne Valley coach, I would slow it down, try and consume as much time with the ball as possible. I mean, the game is almost practically in the bag.
Yeah, definitely. Here we go, Wayne Valley's ball.
Quick pass around, and it is almost stolen away by Jill Konarski. Struggle for the ball, and Jill does come up with it. And it seems to be a jump ball. And it will look to be Wayne Hill's ball. Kristen Lake, the senior, checking back into the game for the fourth quarter. Passing it into Kim Beattie. Kim Beattie has not been out for more than almost a minute of the game. She's played almost the entire game. Jill Konarski looking. Quick passes out. Oh, a little scramble for the ball. Back to Konarski. Looking. Shot goes. Oh, it is blocked and is stolen away by Wayne Valley. Erin Burke has it. Erin Burke just showing off her speed and aggression on both offense and defense. Strong pass to Jessica Slachter.
Valley just passing it around, trying to milk the clock down right now. And here's the dribble in.
Wayne Hill's trying to use a double team to just get the ball back. Kristen Lake steals it away. Kim Beattie now taking it up. Looking back, Hill's just trying to find an open and clean shot. Konarski up, and it is just short. Number 42 gets the defensive rebound. Pass around to Jessica Konarski. Looking, Erin Burke passing around. Haven't crossed, and they're in the key now. Looking, and it's stolen away by Kim Beattie. Kim Beattie just saw the opportunity and just took the ball away. Beautiful, beautiful defense against with this. Oh! Erin Burke showing her speed again and just comes up with the rebound.
Again.
Valley finally makes it in. Great defense leads to a great offense.
Valley showing their D, and they got the fast break and got the points. Oh, nice.
Erin Burke taking it up. Again, just this girl does not look tired at all. She's just so fast. Pass back. Shot goes up on number 50 and is off the back. Here come in the substitutions for Wayne Valley, number 23, number 33, and number 40. Jessica Pastria, number, and Saria Turnus. Kim Beattie takes it up, looking, quick shot, and it is good. A nice offensive drive by the freshman, Kim Beattie.
I think if she gets used to doing that, she'll either get the two or go to the line for the foul. Another three by Wayne Valley. No basket. Another foul. And here's Wayne Hills.
Seems Wayne Hills senior Ashley Kennison will be going to the line for her foul shots of today's game. Her first set. Oh, and just misses. Struggle for the rebound, number 23, Saria Turnus comes up with it.
Note the clock.
And it goes out of bounds. Wayne Hills ball. Kristen Lake to inbound. 5:10 remaining. The score is 68-22. Kim Beattie taking her time. Just trying to get an open lane for a shot. Loses the ball and it goes out of bounds.
Looks like it'll still be Wayne Hill's ball right here. 5 minutes to go. The score is 68-22, Wayne Valley.
Inbound in. Ash Kenson driving hard and is off the front of the rim and just short. The struggle again for the ball and it comes up as Valley ball.
Wayne Valley trying to get the fast break lead, but Wayne Hills gets back.
Again, Valley just killing the clock. A tough pass out of bounds by number 40. Jessica Pasercia. Pass inbound comes in from Kristen Lake. Kim Beattie taking it up. Kim Beattie just taking her time. The clock ticks away with 4:28 remaining. Quick pass out. Looking. Hills are going around the horn. Oh, loses the ball between her legs. And the Valley offense is just going to try and kill as much as the clock. Defense is just on top of their game from all age levels. And just Valley now showing their height, just taking over.
Wayne Hills with the ball again. Just dribbling it up. Goes in. Fight for the ball. Looks like it'll be
a jump ball Valley. For Wayne Valley. Wayne Valley's number 33 inbounds it. Looking around.
3:30 remaining.
Pass just going around the horn, looking for someone, just wasting more time. Oh, and it was tipped off. And a tough slide on her knee and a penalty call.
3:28 remaining.
And it seems that it shall be Valley going to the line, number 23, Saria Turnus.
They're both in the penalty right here, Dan, with both having 7 fouls between each other. And there's a shot, in and out.
Jill Kararski with the great defensive rebound, passes over to Kristen Lake. Kristen Lake just driving around to the side, passes to Kararski. Kararski quick over to Dana Bilecki. Beattie looking, passes over to Dana. Dana looks, puts it up, and it is good with the foul. She will go to the line. So with 3:06 remaining, the score is 68-22. Kelly Lake seems to be checking in at the next buzzer. Kim Beattie is over talking to her coach, Percy.
Wayne Hills looks like they're waking up, but I think it'll be too little too late for them, and Wayne Valley will pull out with the victory. Well, let's see what happens, though, Dan.
Dana Black with her first shot, and it's off the rim and in. Kristen Lake comes out of the game. In for her seems to be Yellis Badbeck, number 20, a junior. Number 23 for Wayne Valley, coming in hard, passes it out. The constant pass, back and forth, just draining time on this Wayne Hills team. Honestly, I think it is too late, and I believe Wayne Valley has taken this game for the win. The travel is called and shall be Wayne Hills ball.
Wayne Hills going in for...
In checking in now is Heather Ash, a sophomore, number 15. Heather Ash passes it over to fellow sophomore Dana Bilecki. Bilecki taking it over midcourt. Quick pass, and it is taken away by Wayne Valley's defense. Again, just showing, and Ashley Kennison just showing her frustration. It's just going to be Wayne Valley ball. 2:27 remaining on the clock. As Heather Ash is set to inbound the ball.
Number 23 checks in for Wayne Hills.
Hey, Andrea Ostrich, another freshman. Dana Blackie looking, playing against a tough, tough defense. Shot goes up and it is just wide. Number 13 with the rebound for Wayne Valley. Wayne Valley now coming across midcourt, taking it, showing some speed and then just slowing down, killing more time. Wayne Hills defense is just trying to do anything to get the ball back and score some points.
A lot of jump balls in this game, Dan, and looks like Wayne Valley will have the ball here. Passing.
It's just the two teams showing so much desire and aggression and going for the ball. That's what you want in a good, clean game. Number 33 puts it up and he's just short. Goes out of bounds, Wayne Hills ball. Coach Ziza passes it over to the official. Heather Ash inbounds it to now new sub number 32, Janine Santoro, a junior.
First appearance in this game, Dan.
With a minute and 48 remaining, the score is 68-25. Heather Ash looking for an open teammate. Staggering, falling back. Quick pass over to Janine Santoro. Santoro also struggling with this tough, tough Valley defense. Passes over to Yellis Babbeck. Yellis looking. Quick pass. Oh, and he's taken away again by this amazing Valley defense. And a penalty is called on the shot. She will get two shots.
Number 42 for Wayne Valley.
Kristen Wardrop. It's just, Valley is just relentless against this Wayne Hills team. Just taken away. No, he's there with us.
She's at the line, too.
The first shot.
And it's good there, Dan.
Santoro inbound. The Wayne Hills team knows that time is running out. Minute and 21 remaining. Score 69-25. Heather Ash looking. Quick pass out to Santoro. Santoro passes back. Looking. Shot. Oh, and it's off the backboard and just over the rim. Can't make it in.
Oh, it looks like, though, they're going to get the foul from Wayne Valley, and Wayne Hills will go to the line.
Number 20, Yellis Babbeck, the junior, to take her shots.
And here we go. Concentrating. Looking for the right angle.
Sets herself. It's up and just wide to the left. Tough shot to miss.
Looks like both defense ready for the offensive rebound if there is. Shoots. And it's good. One out of two for Yellis there.
Janine Santoro with a quick steal. Takes the shot and just misses. Valley recovers the ball. Taken back over midcourt. And now I think they're just going to start keep passing. Oh, no, a shot. Comes up and...
In and out.
In and out. And Kelly Lake with the rebound.
Comes Wayne Hill.
47 seconds remaining on the clock. Heather Ash dribbling back and forth, looking for one more shot. The Valley defense is just not letting up on this Hills offense. They're in their face every play. Another jump ball between Yellis Babbeck and a Valley player. And it shall be Wayne Hills' ball. Stops the clock with 37 seconds remaining. Oh, Valley with the steal again. Valley on the fast break, but there's a travel call.
Wayne Valley just relentless on the D right now. Incredible. They just do not give up, even though there's 34.6 remaining in the game.
Valley playing just amazing defense. The defense has definitely just won the game for them.
Yeah, I think that was the key there, Dan. And they got a couple of fast breaks and came in for the victory here.
I mean, tough, tough defense and a just fast, aggressive offense. It's a great combination to win games. Kelly puts up the shot and it is off the back of the rim and just goes out. Valley on a fast break. Up, and it is over the rim and no good. Valley again with a tough shot, and Janine Santoro goes down hard, and that's the game. Wayne Valley pulls it out 69-26. Thank you for joining. I'm Dan Schleri along with my colleague
Dennis Rivera, and have a nice day. We'll see you next time.
Thank you for joining today's game.